Hey, I'm Sid Schumann of PlayStation Blog, and we're back with Dylan Cuthbert, founder of Q Games. And we've got a new Pixel Junk sensation for you, Pixel Junk Side Scroller. Where did the inspiration for Side Scroller come from? Because you just came out with Pixel Junk Shooter and Pixel Junk Shooter 2.
Yep.
So what's the connection?
Well, when we were making Pixel Junk Shooter 2, while we were making it, we felt this very strong urge to go back to like shooting games roots, and we wanted to make a really old school like side-scrolling shooter. And we thought, well, let's just make it, you know. There's no one stopping us. So we took everything back down to the basics. We made it side-scrolling. We simplified all the controls. It's only a single-stick controller. You have weapon upgrades and enemies and, you know, patterns, attacks and bosses and stuff. And we just really enjoyed ourselves making this. And then we thought, well, what kind of universe can we put this in? Do we need a universe, you know, or a story or a backstory? And we thought, well, let's use the Shooter 2, or like the end of Shooter 2. And all the survivors are on their way back to Earth in their little escape pods. And they're playing this game on the mini computer, like on the pods. And that's when all the idea came. Well, let's make the screen look like it's like an old monitor, like an old vacuum tube, you know, a CRT monitor. And so we started putting all these effects, and we distorted it a bit. We've got like scan lines and a nice sort of glow effect. It looks a bit like a vector display. And
it looks gorgeous, and of course, plenty of particle effects. I was noticing that earlier. Man, yeah. I'll tell you what, particle effects never get old. How are you? You're just pumping out a tremendous number of particle effects. Are you using the same technology you use for Pixel Junk Shooter?
Yes, yeah, we use the same technology to do the effects with a lot of adjustments, though, to get a more stylized. Well, not more stylized, but like a different stylized look to get this sort of feeling of like an older computer, I suppose, a sort of retro neon sort of glow to the thing.
And this will look familiar to Pixel Junk Shooter fans here. We've got like a lava-like substance coming down.
If you notice, the lava is actually made up of like cubes, like little squares. So we kind of digitalized it all. The water is like made up of like little circles, and there's a lot of other liquids in there which are completely different looking. And it's just, we really went to town on making it look like, taking it back to like sort of the 80s sort of digital sort of revolution era, sort of, you know, that kind of.
Yeah, so kind of it's stuff. I mean, there's always a twist though with the Pixel Junk game. I mean, this isn't just a side-scrolling shooter, I'm sure. What other like Easter eggs and just tidbits and secrets do you guys have packed in this game?
Well, a lot of those are secrets. I mean, the main thing really is like the amount of different types of weapons we're going to put in there. So I mean, that's what we're really. You know, here, like, the weapon's been upgraded there, so if they fire, there we go. And you see it's like a big spread shot. And so in Shooter 1 and Shooter 2, there wasn't any kind of this sort of weapons upgrade stuff going on. And so we really tried to put this in as, like just to make it fun. And there's checkpoints now, so people who have trouble with the game, they can quickly just nip back to the previous checkpoint. The game is, you know, it's a little bit old school, so it feels a bit hard at times, but the way we designed it is that even people who have trouble with it can easily pop back a little bit and just replay the section again.
And I'm still seeing like interactive environmental hazards here, the way the Pixel Junk Shooter, of course, innovated in that category. So how does that play into side-scroller here?
For side-scroller, it really is just like hazards, and there isn't so much of a puzzle element in this one. This is really kind of, it is really shooting. It's like hardcore, old school, you know, retro, but kind of, it's kind of the retro game that, you know, you remember them being very awesome, but if you go back and play them, they're a bit too hard, or they're a bit not quite as good as you remember them.
Or not as pretty as you remembered it.
Yeah, stuff like that. So we've kind of gone back and we thought, well, let's make sure it's actually modernized and actually still feels really good. And we're really happy with the result, you know, yeah.
It's beautiful. Well, let's see if any of our fans on Twitter have any questions about Side-Scroller. What do we have so far here, Jeff?
We just got this one in from Nick Lore. Who is doing the music for Side Scroller?
Oh, okay. It's the same people for Pixel Junk Shooter, so High Frequency Bandwidth. And we told them about the concept of the game, and they were like really like hyped up about it. And so they've given us these really cool tracks, which are different to Shooter 1 and Shooter 2. They're much more sort of almost retro in a sense. And they have this kind of like... very hardcore sounds to them. They're really, really cool. I mean, you can probably hear them a bit playing here. But They're really nice. They remind me kind of like how I remember Amiga games, like the music in Amiga, like soundtracker type sounds, but like modernized again, you know, like brought forward to 2011.
Forgive me for not, because I couldn't, it's, even though we're so, you know, how loud it is and barely hear.
Yeah.
You talk about like the curvature of the screen. I mean, it looks like an old arcade cabinet.
Exactly, yeah. When people walk by, when we had it on down on the booth here, when people walk by, they kind of look twice because they think, why is someone got like an old monitor here, you know? But then they look again and it's actually on a flat screen display.
Yeah, it looks like there's like a burn-in. Maybe.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
that's really awesome. Actually, there was one other question, not directly related to side-scroller,
okay.
But it's a question I believe you've answered in the past, but we're here for fan service. It was Akira 1510 wants to know, what does Pixel Junk mean?
Pixel Junk was an old nickname I used on a Japanese language blog in Japan, obviously. Where I used to write up, and I still do occasionally, I used to write up technology posts in Japanese to try and encourage Japanese programmers to learn more about Western, you know, Western programming techniques or technology or graphic techniques. And I kind of thought up the nickname on the spur of the moment. And then when, that was like about 7 or 8 years ago, and then when we started this series and I wanted a name for it, I thought, that's actually a very, very good name to use for it. And then I thought about it more, and it actually fits in with the style of the games, and you know, it gives a kind of a nostalgic sort of retro sound. And the junk just kind of, you know, when games used to crash, you know, and you know, on the Super Nintendo, you know, you fiddle with the cartridge a bit, and you get noise on the screen and stuff. Well, that's kind of the fun side of, you know, of
kind of a lo-fi feeling. Yeah,
exactly.
We've seen that in all the Pixel Junk games, including side scroller here, which we're looking at now. And what's your favorite part of the game? What's your favorite moment of the game, your favorite element of the game?
Probably one of my favorites is the boss battle, which is really cool. It has like, we have this big boss that comes on and he fires like missiles up into the screen and like, they drop down and you have to dodge them. Very, very old school. And
very
you're like
cool.
You're just shooting into his mouth and things. It's good fun.
Very cool. Classic and modern. Classic Pixel Junk.
Yeah.
So that was side scroller.